Good morning students. So far we have started the sets and we have learned few basic concepts. Now we will study the important topic of this chapter, that is operation on sets. So there are two type of operation on the sets. First is union of set and second one is intersection of sets. Okay. So what is the meaning of union of sets and what is the meaning of intersection of sets? So first of all we will discuss this one. Suppose I have a set A and I have a set B. Then union of set is denoted by A union B. And it means that X is such that X belongs to A and X belongs to B. So that means all the elements of A and B should be there. For example, suppose I take a set A is equals to 1, 2, 3. And suppose if I take a set B is equals to suppose 3, 5, 6. So A union B means all the elements which are in both the sets A and B. Like 1, 2, 3, all the elements of A. Now since 3 is already there, so we will not write 3, then 5 and 6. Okay, repetitive elements we never count whenever we do the union of the sets. So this is the meaning of union of two sets. Okay, so let's discuss our exercise 6.2. Now in this few questions are there. So first of all you remember this thing, this is important, that A union B is always equal to B union A. Okay, it will always follow whatever the things are there. So suppose a question is given that if P is a set of factors of 10. So if I calculate the factors of 10, this is in description method. So first we have to calculate, convert it into the roster form. Okay. So this is your set P. And Q is such that it is a natural number and this natural number is less than 10. That means this 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 until 9 we will write. Okay, now if you wish to calculate P union Q, so what this P union Q will contain? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and all the natural numbers till 10. Okay, so this is how you will calculate the union of two sets. Okay, like this. Then suppose a question is, now suppose a set is there, and one more set I am writing, X such that X belongs to whole number and X lies between 3 and 8. One more set is given, C. So whenever you want to calculate the union of sets, always remember the set should be in the roster form. So A is already there in the roster form. First we will write the elements of B. So elements of B, like I have told you, it means X is greater than 3. That means all the values, whole numbers greater than 3, 5, 6, 7 and it should be less than 8. So this is your set B. Now we will write C in the roster form. So all the natural numbers which are less than equal to, okay, this sign is of less than or equal to, remember this sign. That means all the natural numbers which are less than as well as equal to 5. So this will be your C. Now what we have to calculate in this, we have to calculate first A union B. So B means all the elements which are in A.
So I can write all the elements of A then,
as well as all the elements in B.
So 5, 6, 7 is already there, we will write only 4. So this will be your A union V, and you can write 4 here or you can write 4 here also.
Okay, there will be no problem. Sequence of elements does not matter. Then suppose we have to calculate B union C. So first you write all the elements of B,
4, 5, 6, 7.
Then we will write the elements from set C which are not present here. So what is not present here? 1, 2 and 3. So this will be your B union C. Then we will write A union C. So elements of A, I am writing all the elements of A. Now elements of C which are not there in A, that is 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, like this you can calculate the union of the sets. So remember few things are there. First you will write, if a set is given in set builder or description form, then first you will write the set in the roster form like I have written this. Then you will, if you want to write A union B, then you write all the elements of A first. Then from B you will choose the elements which are not present here, like what was not present here, 4 was not there, rest all the elements were there, so I have written only 4. Like this you can calculate the union of two sets. So let's discuss one more question. Suppose a set is given like this and one more set B is given like this. So like I have told you, first we will convert this set into the roster form. So first we will take this inequality, that means it is x plus 1 less than 8. Then this 1 will go there, so you will get x less than 8 minus 1 or x less than 7. That means now we can replace this x plus 1 less than 8 by x less than 7. So what will be your set A? Set A will be all the natural numbers which are less than 7, that is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6. Similarly, now we will calculate this. So I will take x plus 3 less than equal to 5. This 3 will come here. X plus 3, x less than equal to 5 minus 3. That means x is less than equal to 2. So now this we can replace by x is less than equal to 2. So what will be your set B? Set B will be all the natural numbers which are less than as well as equal to. Okay, this is equal to sign. That means 1 and 2. So this will be your set B. Now if I want to calculate A union B, so what will be my A union B then? First all the elements of A I will write 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. And in B elements are 1 and 2, that is already written. So this will be your A union B. Okay. Then let's discuss one more question. In this, Oscar. So now again this set is given in the set builder form. So first we will write the elements of the set, that is all the prime numbers that are less than 10. So that is 2, 3, 5 and 7. Okay. Remember 1 is not a prime number. Many times you all are written 1 as a prime number. So 1 is not a prime number. So never take 1 in the prime number list. This will be your prime number less than 10. Then we will write set B. All the odd numbers which are less than 10, that means 1, 3, 5, 7, 9. Then C set is an even number which is less than 10, so 2, 4, 6, 8. Okay, now we have written all the three sets in the roster form. Now we will start solving. So first part, that is we have to prove A union B is equals to B union A. So first, what is A union B? elements of A, 2, 3, 5, 7. Then elements of B, which are not in A1 and 9. This will be A union B. Then we will calculate B union A, all the elements of B, and the element which are in A but not in B, that is 2. So you can see that all the elements are there in A union B and B union A. So we can write A union B is equal to B union A. Okay, so this is hence true. Then next is we have to prove that A union C is equals to C union A. So first we will write A union C. So 2, 3, 5, 7, then 4, 6, and 8. This is your A union C. Then we will calculate C union A. Elements of C, that is 2, 4, 6, 8. And the elements of C which are not present in A, that is 3, 5, 7. So now again you can see 2, 3, 5, 7, 2, 3, 5, 7, 4, 6, 8, 4, 6, 8. So we can write A union C is equals to C union A. Like this. Then the third one is, we have to calculate A union B union C. So in these type of questions, first what we will calculate? First we will calculate B union C. So what is our A set? We can write it like this, 2, 3, 5, 7. This will be your A. And what is your B union C? B union C will be 1, 3, 5, 7, 9, 2, 4, 6, 8. Okay, this will be your B union C. So what is their union? Their union will be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Okay, so this will be their union. Then we have to calculate A union B union C. So first we will calculate A union B. A union B is 1, 2, 3, 5, 7, 9. Union set C is 2, 4, 6, 8. So what is the answer of this? Answer will be 1, 2, 3, 5, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Okay, so you can see that this value is equal to this value. So we can write that A union B union C is equals to A union B union C. Okay, this property is actually known as associative property, which you have studied in the previous class. Okay, like this you can prove the values. Okay, one more type. Suppose now questions is in the form of the words. So what are the elements of A? Okay, I, then N, then O, then B, then A, then T, then E. Okay, repetitive letters you will not count. So this will be your elements of A. Then we will write elements of B, that is M, A, T, H, E, I, C, S. Okay, repetitive elements we are not counting. Only distinct elements we are taking into account. So first thing which is asked, A union B. So again same method we will use. First I will write all the letters of A, that is I N O B A T E. Okay, now the letters which are not present in A but present in B, that is M. Then A is there, T was there, then H is not there, then E was there, then I was there, then C was not there, then S. So this will be your A union B. Okay, don't write the repetitive elements.
or if you are having any problem in visualizing this, then you can cut the repetitive elements like I have cut in, then I have cut E and E was there, then A and A was there, then T and T was there. Okay, so these were the repetitive elements. Now you can easily see the unique elements which are there in this. Then second part is we have to calculate A union B is equals to B union A. So this is my A union B. Now I will calculate B union A. So B union A means again, first we will write all the elements of B. Then we will not write the repetitive elements and O B. So you can easily see that both the sets contain the same elements. That means we can write A union B is equals to B union A. Hence, true. Stop the video.